Wouldn't it be great to have a WordPress website created by a professional designer? In this video, I'm sharing a tip that digital agencies use to deliver beautiful websites to their clients. And the best part? You can have a beautiful website too, in less than 15 minutes. For the best digital agency tech hacks for bloggers and small business owners, be sure to click that subscribe button so you can be the first to know when I upload a brand new video. And be sure to stay tuned all the way till the end of the video because I'll be sharing with you my best tip on how to crush your goals for 2019. I mean, who doesn't want a beautiful website that looks like a professional designed it? If you're new here, my name is Kate Murray. I worked in corporate and agency marketing for 14 years and I've helped hundreds of people set up their blogs the right way. And now it's your turn to learn the tricks of the trade. First things first, professional designers don't use free blog themes. So if you want to get the quality look of a professionally designed website, you're going to have to invest somewhere between $50 and $150. But in the grand scheme of things, it's not that much when you consider that a lot of businesses spend thousands of dollars on their websites. There are two phenomenal places that you can go to see a working demo of beautiful WordPress themes.
Let's chat about Creative Market first. This is a company based out of San Francisco, California, and the talent absolutely shows. Not only do they have awesome WordPress themes, they have gorgeous fonts and patterns that you can use to complement your brand on your social media channels. It's a great choice for a cohesive website that looks like a professional designed it. They start in price at a relatively low $39, and many of the themes are compatible with an online store. As you can see, you can click on the theme to see a working demo of exactly how it will look when you install it on your website. One thing I should mention is that they also sell Bootstrap HTML themes, Magento, and Joomla themes as well, which you should absolutely not use because those are for something completely different from a WordPress blog. In the comments of this video, you'll find a link where you can click directly over to Creative Market's WordPress themes for bloggers. Choose whichever one visually speaks to you and the look and the feel that you want to create with your website. And know that even though many of these appear very feminine, you will have the opportunity to change the color to just about any color you want.
Deciding on a color scheme for your business can take a really long time. What's your favorite color? Tell me in the comments below.
The other elite vendor that digital agencies use for their themes is StudioPress. What I love about StudioPress is its compatibility with other integrations in the Genesis framework. Now, if you've never heard of the Genesis framework, don't worry. Explanation of other WordPress functionalities is a little beyond the scope of this particular video, so I won't be talking much about that, but I just want to show you that there are some really awesome themes available for sale here, where you can basically preview a demo, import the demo content, and literally change out a few pictures and text and have your website or blog up and running in less than 15 minutes. As you can see, in this demo, you can even look at the responsive design, which means how your site will look on a phone or a tablet. Why should you buy a theme from one of these vendors? Because time is money, and when something is done right the first time, it just works. This is the hack that agencies all over the globe use to deliver beautiful WordPress sites to their clients, and they charge top dollar for it. Isn't it time you jumped on board and learned all the tricks of the trade?
Ready to hear my best tip for growing your blog traffic and your email list in 2019? Create a quiz. To get started, click on the link in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel because next week I'll be talking all about email automation. What's your biggest hurdle in getting started with your blog? Tell me about it in the comments below. See you next time.